Well, today, guys, we have, I think I had put bad gas from AC Martin here, but I got all that stuff cleaned out. So I'm gonna reset the engine computer on this Camaro, and I'm gonna show you how to do that and where the battery is located. So first, I'm gonna start it up and let y'all see that the engine light is on. Just remind me the trunk's open. Yeah, this is 2015 Camaro. I think we got all the bad gas out of it. Put a fuel treatment in it, and now we're gonna reset it. So I'm gonna do this right here. Turn the key, ignition on, but not start it. And then we're gonna go back here and since I don't have my size 10 ratchet, I'm gonna use this. Disconnect the negative battery terminal, and your battery is located in the trunk under the spare tire. So go ahead and loosen this. As you see, I removed the spare tire and the deal. It's just located right here. It's not hard to find. Make sure I don't lose that. Okay, and then just wiggle it a little bit and it should come off. Make sure you leave your key on, or else it won't reset. Leave your key on the on right before you start your engine, leave it in that position. So now we're gonna wait about 35 seconds maybe. This is pretty nice. I ain't never seen this before. I think I need this on my truck so the battery acid don't overflow or something like that. I guess it drains out to under the car. Let me look under here real quick and see. But yeah, this is the exhaust I got done a while back. Nope, it's just a muffler to leave the resonators and stuff, and four catchers still under there in the H pipe. But yeah, wait a couple of seconds before I hook it back up. Just figure I'd do some videos today. As I said in the last video, I have my iPad in lost mode. I'm just waiting for them to connect to the internet. I'm hoping they will. And then I won't have to worry about them getting my iPad and looking at my information and stuff, because it'll lock them right out as soon as they connect to the internet. That's what's good about Apple. They have the Find My iPhone or iPad or whatever you lose. I don't know much about Androids. I don't know if they have that or not. Okay, that should be long enough. I'm going ahead and hook it back up. Or at least try to with one hand. It's kind of hard. And you can hear everything kicking on. I'm trying not to get shocked while I'm doing this. Trunk light came back on. Make sure it's all the way down on that battery. Okay, now I gotta find my wire pliers. I don't know what I did with them. Oh yeah, I do. I remember. Everything's on. Yep, it's resetted. I can already tell. I'll show you a few cool things too while programming the car. Make sure this is good and tight. Yep. It says trunk is open, but oh well. Maybe I should shut it. This is what I find pretty cool about the new Camaros. Let me go ahead and start it. It says closed driver door. Hang on, let me start it up. No more engine light. It says open, then closed driver window. So I'm gonna do that. Then it says open and then close driver. Wait, yeah, it still says the same thing. Hang on. Try this again. Let me see if it's programmed. Yeah, it's programmed. It didn't shut though. try this again. It's freaking hot in here. Now it says open and close passenger window. Doing that right now. And now that's set. And there's no engine light. So I'm gonna put everything back in the trunk that's supposed to be there. And then we're gonna take it for a ride. It's reprogrammed, the whole computer. Like I said, all the bad gas should be out of here, so put this cover back on. Then put the spare tire back in. Snap me about my stolen iPad. Okay. Now that's that. Definitely put it in wrong. Okay, now we're good. It's hot as shit out here. I'm sure if you read the owner's manual, you would know how to do this, but most people, they don't really care about the owner's manual. That should be tight enough. And now we're going. Take it for a test drive so the computer will know what to do. Turn this air on because it's hot as hell. Yeah, everybody's snapping me about the iPad because I put it on Snapchat. I didn't tell who it was that stole it, even though I seen who it was. But oh, I'm in neutral. I told one person who it was. Well, actually two, but didn't tell nobody that we're trying to do something about it because I'm gonna handle it myself. First, I wanted to see if he was gonna be honest and bring it back to my house because he knows it's mine by now because I know he's went through it. I'm praying to God that he tries to. He's probably gonna want to get in my Facebook, but he ain't gonna be able to see like anything until he connects it to the internet. So I'm praying he goes over to his girlfriend's house and tries to connect it to the internet, because when he does that, it's gonna lock up. Because I've programmed it with my iPhone right now, because it's on my, that's what's good about iCloud. It's on my iCloud, so. Okay, that's bright lights, it ain't. Windshield's a little dirty. So, yeah, I set it up through my iCloud. I have like five or six devices on there. And I chose that one, and I set up for it to lock it up. At first I was gonna erase the whole iPad, but I didn't really wanna do that because I wasn't sure if it was gonna erase my iCloud and stuff. And then I really been screwed. I wouldn't been able to track it down or anything because my iCloud had been gone. So I just pressed lock the iPad. And if they get on the internet, which I hope they do, it will lock up as soon as they connect. And it'll show me where it's at. I ain't too happy about the situation, but all I can say is stuff happens. The thing was upwards of a grand. I think it's 1,100, something like that, 1,100. And I seen him steal it, and he's just gonna wave at me like nothing's wrong. And I know the person, that's the bad part, but yeah, I was coming back to see if I could get it from him, and he locked the gate to his house, and he drove up to his house, and I don't know the person that well, so I wasn't gonna go up to his house and try and get it because ain't no telling. He'd probably try to shoot me or something. He's been in prison before, so I'm not going. Yeah, I just rather do it the hard way instead of the easy way and end up getting killed or something. But yeah, it happened. It sucks ass, but what can you do about it? And the car is driving fine. No engine light, no sputtering, no spickering, no nothing. That'd be the last time I get Easy Mart gas from Rice City. But we're doing good so far. Need to put some more gas in it. Oh man. Well, that includes this video. Subscribe for more content. Drop a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Keep it real, and always remember, Jesus loves you.